I'm Anthony F. Elmore, President and Founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association. We at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association are not only the Black Buddhist voice in America, we are the Black Buddhist voice of the world. And today, we bring you another exciting Black Buddhist lecture. Because Kwanzaa is an African-American celebration. Now, one of the things that we do at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, we teach Buddhism inclusive of our Black history, culture, and language. Now, we who are proud Black Buddhists teach Buddhism based on the teachings of the 13th century Black Japanese Buddhist sage, Nichiren Shonin. It is Nichiren Shonin who teaches us that the essence of the Buddhist teachings is the Lotus Sutra, and we're to only practice the Lotus Sutra. Let's talk about Kwanzaa. See, the first day of Kwanzaa is called Umoja. See, Umoja means unity, to strive for and maintain unity in the family, community, nation, and race. Now, Nichiren writes about this unity in a Gosho called Many in Body, One in Mind. It reads, quote, if the spirit of many in body, but one in mind prevails among the people, they will achieve all their goals, whereas one in body, different in mind, they can achieve nothing remarkable, unquote. Now, the second Kwanzaa principle is called Kuji Shakalia. See, Kuji Shakalia, what that means is this, to define ourselves, name ourselves, as well as to create and speak for ourselves. The third principle of Kwanzaa is called Ujima. Now, Ujima means collective work and responsibility. That means to build and maintain our community together and make our brothers and sisters' problems our problems and to solve them together. Now, that's Ujima. In Buddhism, we call this the way of the Bodhisattva. See, the Bodhisattva means to do good to help others. You see, so we get involved in our community, we get involved in our country, and we work to make a better, not only a better America, but we work hard to make a better world. Now, that's Ujima. Now, the fourth is called cooperative economics. That is to build and maintain our stores, shops, and other businesses, and to profit from them together. See, this too is unity. Now, the fifth principle is called Nia. That means purpose. Now, to make our collective vocation the building and development of our community in order to restore our people to their traditional greatness. See, we at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association fight hard to change the ghetto into greatness. Let me give you an example. I want you to look at this house. Now, this altar was made in Accra, Ghana. Everything in this house is an African heritage. It relates our African culture. It relates our history. When you look at the clothes I wear this is a kente cloth made in Ghana. So we support cooperative economics. We have created jobs. And we made our neighborhood better than what it is before we moved here. For example, I live in a Black neighborhood in Memphis called Orange Mound. Orange Mound is the first Black neighborhood in America that was built for Blacks by Blacks. In fact, in the movie Hustle and Flow, there were some young men just right in this neighborhood. They got the first Grammy Award for the song It's Hard Out Here Being a Pimp. The Orange Mound hip-hop group 3-6 Mafia found Nia a purpose in their own neighborhood. They didn't have to go out to some oriental to look outside themselves. They looked within themselves and they found gold in their own backyard. They became the first hip-hop group in America to win an Academy Award with rap music. They found this within inside themselves. See, this is how you do things. Like we in this house, if you look at our house, we decided not to go outside of our community, but to look within our culture, our history, our language. And when you look at our house here, you look on the outside, you see a gold house, you see the African carvings, you see the history, the culture, you walk inside this house and you see the Lotus Sutra doors. See, Buddhism is not outside yourself. Buddha exists within you. We all have a Buddha nature. And the sixth principle of Kwanzaa takes us to that Buddha nature. The sixth principle of Kwanzaa is called Kuamba. Now, Kuamba means creativity. It means to always, as much as we can, in a way we can, in order to leave our community more beautiful and beneficial than we inherited. You see, the principle of Kwanzaa is a Buddhist principle, and that a Buddhist principle means doing good. It means coming into your community and building your community, making your community first rate. We don't have to look outside ourselves to find our dignity, our culture, our pride. We can find these things inside ourselves, and we can be the model for the next generation. I don't have to go to some Asia to find a Buddha or to find Buddhism. Buddha exists within yourself. Now, again, the sixth principle is called Kuamba, or creativity. It takes creativity to write these Black Buddhist lectures, but you find the creativity within yourself. And now, the word Imani, it means faith in the language of Swahili. Now, and it says to believe with all our hearts in our people, our parents, our teachers, our leaders, and the righteousness and victory of our struggle. See, our struggle in Buddhism is to fight the racism. Our Buddhist struggle is to challenge the Asians and whites who extricated all of our Black Buddhist history, culture, and language. You see, in the Go Show, the real aspect of the Gohanzan, it tells us an important, or teaches us an important lesson on faith. It reads, quote, to have faith is the basis of Buddhism. Thus, the fourth volume of Concentration and Insight states, quote, Buddhism is like an ocean that one can only enter with faith, unquote. The fourth volume of the Annotations on the Great Concentration Insight explains this, quote, with regard to the phrase, Buddhism is like an ocean that one can only enter with faith. Even Confucius taught that faith is first and foremost. How much more so is this true with the profound doctrines of Buddhism? Without faith, how could we possibly enter? The way to enter Buddhahood and to find the happiness that the Buddhist practice brings is to have faith in yourself, have faith in your community, have faith in who you are, have faith in our nation. This is who we are as Buddhists. We are proud Black Buddhists, people who have faith. See, Buddhahood is not looking outside yourself. Anyway, let me bring this proud Black Buddhist lecture to a conclusion. We've covered the seven principles.
Oh yeah. Happy Kwanzaa. Happy Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa. Feel the joy as we sing of the love togetherness can surely bring
emotion.
Set the table at a strong, thankful for the first fruits of the year. Stay a light a candle just for you. Come join the party, it's a celebration. Karamu at Kwanzaa time of year. Red and yellow, black or white, you're it's alright. It's a celebration that should last throughout the year.
Happy Kwanzaa.
Happy Kwanzaa. All right. Together there is so much we can do.
Happy Kwanzaa.
All right.
Happy Kwanzaa.
It's a celebration. Remembering times of old. Tradition is the food that fills our souls. Yes, it does. Still the children are future of all our hopes and dreams. Let's teach them well. Let's teach them well. Come join the party. It's a celebration. Karamu at Kwanzaa time of the year. Red and yellow, black or white. Yellow, it's alright. It's a celebration that will last throughout the year.
Happy Kwanzaa.
All right.
Happy Kwanzaa.
Everybody.
Happy Kwanzaa.
Together there is so much we can do. Happy, 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 happy Kwanzaa. So many ways to show I love you. See, I have faith in all that we do. But we gotta stay together. Just a few of the principles that help us carry on.
Happy Kwanzaa.
Together. There's so much, so much we can do. 'Cause it's a celebration.
Starts at 8, that's when we get praise to the man upstairs for another blessed day. I give hugs to my moms, my dad and my sis. You smell that? I run to see what moms cook.
While we drink from the cup of togetherness, it's that part of the year that you don't want to miss. I give a gift from the heart so you know it's true. So recite a principle and tell me what it means to you.
Creativity.